Hello students, we are continuing with the questions of past adjustment, that is with question number 57 of the exercise 57. Children, in my last video I had explained you the how to do the questions of past adjustments and the guarantee. Okay, these two concepts I had explained you, and today we are starting with the questions of past adjustments. The first question: Ria, Mona and Nisha are sharing profits in 3-1. After the profits for the 3 years were 1,40,84 and 1,06,000. These profits were by mistake distributed equally. The error is now to be corrected. So there is a default in crediting the profit to them in a particular ratio. It was to be credited in 3-1, but it is now credited as equally. So, but here we can see that the partners are sharing profits in 3-1. It is only specified like this. Means they were sharing in 3-1 only. There was no change in the profit sharing. Sometimes in the question it is given that 1 year they are sharing in 3-1, in another year they are sharing in 5-4-1, in another they would be sharing equally. At that time we have to divide those profits differently. But here we can add the 3 years profits and we can divide among the partners. Okay, so now see, first we will see the working notes over here. The profits of all the 3 years will be added, 84,000. And then 1,06,000. Okay, we will add the profit of these 3 years. Now after this, this is 3,30,000. This was divided equally. So divide equally into 3. So it is 1,10,000. This was wrongly given to them, wrongly credited to them. But actually, it has to be credited in 3-1. So now if you divide 3,30,000 divided by 6, 3, 4, 5, 6. So accordingly, one part will be 6, 5 is a 30. Again 3, 6, 5 is a 30. So one share is 55,000. So that way we will multiply it by 2 and 3 and we will do the working. So actually it is to be credited as 55,000. Then 110 and then 165 in the ratio 3:2:1. Okay, this is the working note that what actually was done and what should be done. After calculation of this, we will be preparing the statement, that is, as I told you, with the debit credit method only. Now there are three partners, in all there are three partners, so particulars. A very simple statement. Here you will write adjustment table, Priya, Mona. Okay, no need to prepare so big. So Priya, Mona and Nisha, and this is form. Okay, this is of the form. Again, two parts which will be debit, credit. Okay, then here we will write profits wrongly credited of 3 years. Okay, the wrongly which was credited as equally. So wrongly credited, so now we will take back from them. So it will be debited to their accounts. The wrong amount will be debited and the correct to be given will be credited. Okay, so this is equal 110, and the 3,30,000 will be credited in firm's account. 3,30,000. Okay, now profits to be correctly credited in 3:2:1, which we have, I have already shown you in the working note. So this is 1,65,000, this is 1,10,000, and this is 55,000. So here it will be 3,30,000. Firm's accounts gets automatically closed. Okay, 330. Now you have to close this by finding the difference. Difference of Rhea's account. Credit side is more, 165. Here also it will be 165. Subtract 110, difference is 55,000. So he will be, Rhea will be credited in the journal entry, because Rhea's credit balance is more than the debit balance. Same way Mona and Rhea. Mona's account is already balanced, means Mona is neither losing nor gaining in that wrong done thing by them, by the partners. She is neither gaining nor losing, so no effect to her. Here debit side is more, so 1,10,000, 1,10,000, and here it will be, again difference will be 55,000. So he, Nisha will be debited in the journal entry. Okay, this is how you have to pass the, you have to make this adjustment table, and then you have to find the what should be debited and credited. This way Nisha's account will be debited by 55,000 and Rhea's account will be credited by 55,000 in order to nullify the effect. After this, students, even a single journal entry has to be passed. You have to make the format of the journal and write the journal entry over here as Nisha's capital account debit to Rhea's capital account. Okay, being the adjustment entry passed for wrong distribution of profits. Adjustment entry passed for the wrong distribution of profits. 55,000, 55,000. That's it. This is how you will pass the journal entry. The word capital account or current account should be used with the name of the partner. In case of fixed capital accounts, we will be using current account, and fluctuating, you are using the capital account. Okay, so accordingly this journal entry has to be passed. See the next question. PQ are sharing profits and losses equally. Their fixed capitals were 2 lakhs and 3 lakhs respectively. Now when it is specified, their fixed capital means they are maintaining on the fixed capital method. The partnership deed provided for interest on capital at 12% per annum for the year ending 31st March. Profits for the year were distributed without providing for interest on capital. It means it was agreed in the partnership deed, but it was not provided to the partners. And now you have to rectify the error. So 12% of 2 lakhs and 3 lakhs, first we will see, I calculate. I have prepared the adjustment table. Now interest on capital to be given at 12% per annum. Okay, so 2 lakhs 12% is 24,000, correct? 12 twos are 24 and 12 threes are 36, and he will be given 36,000. Naturally, see over here, the interest on capital was to be given and it was not provided. So you have to credit to the partner's account, okay, and debit to the firm's account. So 24,000 credit, 36,000 credit, plus both, and 60,000 will be debited. Correct? Now you have to close the firm's account. Firm's account debit balance is there, so it will be a loss. 60,000, 60,000. This loss of 60,000 will be distributed among the partners equally. Loss to be distributed equally. Okay, so 30-30, 30,000 and 30,000. That's it. And we will find the difference of the partners' accounts. Correct? Here you can see debit side is more. So 30,000. Here also it will be 30,000. 30 minus 24, difference is 6,000. As the debit side is more, P will be debited in the entry. Similarly, his credit side is more. 36,000, 36,000. 6,000 will come on the debit side. As the credit side is more, the partner will be credited in the general entry. Now, as the capitals are fixed, the general entry which you will pass will be P's current account debit, please, current account debit 6,000 to Q's current account. Okay, to Q's current account, and the narration will be being interest on capital 12% credited to the partners, which was being the adjustment entry passed for the interest on capital at 12% not credited to the partners. That way you will write the narration and complete the question. Children, the next question, 59, is the same. That interest on capital was not provided to them. So that you do it on your own. We are starting with question number 60. Okay. Question number 60. Now see, I am 60, 61, I will be explaining together. And then we will be doing those questions. Ram, Mohan, Sohan are partners, sharing profits and losses equally. Capitals were 120, 90 and 60 respectively. For the year ending 31st March 20, interest was credited to them at 6% instead of 5%. What has happened? 1% has been credited more. It was to be credited at 5%, but wrongly it was credited to them at 6%. So obviously we have to take 1% back from them. Okay, we will take 1% back from them, and that profit of 1% will be given to them equally. Same way in the next question, 61. Ram, Shyam, Mohan are partners in 212. Ratio is 212. The fixed capitals were 3 lakh, 1 lakh and 2 lakhs. For the year 31st March 20, interest was credited to them at 9% instead of 10%. Here 1% is given less. Okay, it was to be given 10%, but it was given 9%. Instead of 10, it was credited 9. So 1% you have to give more to them. In this question, 1% you have to give more to them. So we will not do like this. See, in some books it is explained like this also, that you first take 6% back from them and then give 5% to them. No need to labor so much so with that. Only the difference, whatever has been credited more or less, either will be taken back or given to the partners in such a case. Okay, so we will start doing these two questions. Now in this game, in the next one, it is also said that profit for the year before charging interest was 2,50,000. Show the working notes for the and pass the adjustment entry. Now, children, always remember that profits, though they are given 2,50,000, but the effect of the profit may not be given in the adjustment table. The reason? It is not said that profits are distributed in a wrong proportion. It means profits were given in the correct proportion to them. So only the effect of the interest on capital wrongly credited or wrongly debited will be made in the adjustment table. But if it is said that this profit was wrongly divided equally, instead of 2-1-1, or it was divided in a particular ratio instead of 2-1-2, then in that case the effect of profit will also come in the adjustment table. Okay. Now, interest on capital was credited to them 1% more. So 1% of their capitals we will debit to their accounts, means we will take back from them. It was credited as 6% instead of 5%. So you have to give 5%, but you have given 6%. So 1% we are taking back, credited to their account. This profit of 2700. Profits distributed equally. Okay, so 27, so it is 9. Okay, 3 9s are 27. So 900, 900, and 900. The difference will be, we will close this 1200, 1200. Difference is 300. So Ram will be debited. Here there is no balance, no difference. Mohan's account will be closed as it is. This side credit is more. So 300 will be on this side. So his account will be credited. So your journal entry you have to pass by making the format of journal. Okay. I will not be doing that now. You have to pass it, pass the correct entry in your fair copies. Ram's capital account debit to Sohan's capital account. It is not specified that the capitals are fixed, but in the next question it is said their capitals were fixed at 3 lakh, 1 lakh, 2 lakh. So there you will pass the entry with the current account. Okay. Now in this question, one person was credited less to the partners. Instead of 10%, it was credited as 9%. So we are providing 1% of the interest on capital to them, which is credited to all the three partners' capital account and debited to the firm's account. This loss of the firm of 6,000. Okay, this is the loss because it is on the debit side. This loss of 6,000 will be divided in 2-1-2. It won't be divided equally. It will be divided in the profit sharing ratio. So this is 5 ones are 5, 5 twos are 10, 1200. 1200 is one part. So 2400, 1200 and 2400. So loss to be divided in 2-1-2. So one part is 1200. So one part was with Shyam, so loss is there, so it will be debited 1200, 2400 and 2400. This is how you have to give them the loss. Now close the accounts of this partners also as we were balancing. Credit side is more, 3000, 3000. Difference will be on this side and Ram will be credited with the difference amount. Here also debit side is more, 1200 1200, so here it will be 200, so he will be debited with 200. Here also debit side is more, 2400, so 400. This partner will also be debited with that account. Okay. You have to pass the journal entry with this difference amount, children. Please remember, we have made the adjustment, whatever we have given less, we have provided to them. Whatever gear we have given wrong is taken back from them. And finally, with these figures, you have to pass the journal entry. Now, two partners' accounts are to be debited. The partners' capital's accounts are fixed. Remember that. So, the journal entry will be Shyam's current account debit with 200, Mohan's current account debit with 400, to Ram's current account credit with 600. Okay, being interest on capital credited less to the partners, now the adjustment entry has been passed. Children, question number 62 is bit tricky, you can say complicated, so better pay attention for that. Simrat and Beer are partners in the firm sharing profits in 3:2. On 31st March, after closing the books of accounts, their capital account stood at 4,80,000 and 6,00,000. Now the date is on 31st March, after closing the accounts, means it is their closing capitals. Okay. On 1st May, Simrat introduced an additional capital of 1,20,000 and Beer withdrew 60,000 from his capital. On 1st October, Simrat withdrew 2,40,000 from her capital and Beer introduced 3,00,000 as capital. Interest on capital is allowed at 6% per annum. Subsequently, it was noticed that interest on capital at 6% has been omitted. Profits for the year ending was amounted to 2,40,000 and partners drawings has been 1,20,000 and 60,000. Compute for interest on capitals as per fixed method and fluctuating method. Now, we all know that interest on capital is to be provided on their opening capitals only. So first I am showing you the calculation of opening capital as per fixed capital method. Now see students, if you see this, I am preparing this the capital account of Simrat. Okay, Simrat's capital account, which I have explained you under the fixed capital and fluctuating capital methods. Here we write balance brought down, that is the opening balance. Okay, here we have the closing balance, balance carried down. You see the fixed capital method, the partners. Only under two circumstances the capital balance will change. Either the capital has been introduced or it has been withdrawn from the firm. So here we write the additional capital and here we write the withdrawals. Okay. Except this four, there is nothing else in the fixed capital method. I have explained only for Simrat. So now this is the statement to calculate the opening capitals of the partners first. But the partners have changed their capitals in between. So at whatever time on 1st May, now if you say the year starts from 1st April 19 till 31st March 20, correct? On 1st April, they had the opening capital, this one. On 1st May, there was some change. On 1st October, there was some change. So, interest on capital will also change. Interest on capital will be provided on the basis of the capital introduced or withdrawn by the partner during the year. Or we can say that for what time period you have used the capitals of the partners. Okay, so we will see this. The formula to calculate the opening capital, you can see closing capital plus withdrawals minus additional capital. At whatever dates they have provided, dates and all that we will continue in the next part of calculating the interest on capitals. Okay. Children, you can see here the opening capital as per the fixed capital method. Okay. The formula to calculate the opening capital, which I had explained you by preparing that format. Closing capitals, add draw withdrawals, subtract additional capital. You will get the opening. So that this is provided to you 4,80,000, 6,00,000 plus 2,40,000 and 60,000. This. Okay. They have introduced and withdrawn in an opposite way. Okay. The withdrawals of Simrat. This has been withdrawn on 1st October and this has been withdrawn on 1st May. Dates are opposite. Same way he has introduced on 1st May and he has withdrawn on 1st October. But in this calculation of opening capital, these dates are not important. These dates will be taken into account in calculating the interest on capitals as per this method, which I will show it to you. Now, this is the opening. Opening means on 1st April. But this was changed on 1st May only. So, on this figure, You will give 6% but only for 1 month. It cannot be because on 1st May only that capital changed, either due to withdrawals or due to the additional capital introduced in the business. Okay.